Hi friends, my name is Ann Garcon and I'm super excited today to get to share my very first children's book with you. It's called Mommy, How Can I Help You? And it's written by Ann Garcon. That's me. And you are the very first to get to hear me read it out loud. So that's kind of cool. The back of the book, it's a blurb and it shares what the story is about. So let's read that first before we jump in. Melody and Owen's baby sister has just been born and everybody loves her. However, Melody finds mommy crying a lot ever since the baby was born, which is a bit weird for mommy. What could be making mommy cry? Do you have any predictions? Well, let's find out. Mommy is coming home today with our new baby sister. We have waited so long for this day. When mommy was pregnant, we asked her how we could help her when the baby gets here. Mommy loved that we wanted to help, so she told us some ways. I got my notepad to write everything down because I didn't want to forget. My name is Melody, and this is my list. I'm 10 years old. I think I'm a great helper. My brother Owen, on the other hand, is too silly to be a helper. A better role for him can be our baby sister's entertainer because he's so funny. Ways to help mommy. Ask God to bless our new family. Keep the place clean. Be ready to get whatever mommy needs. Have a careful eye ready to watch baby when mommy needs to go to the bathroom. Make mommy breakfast. Listen the first time. Try to keep the noise down. Read to the baby. Draw pictures with lots of colors. While daddy goes off to get mommy and baby, grandma stays with us at home. We're so excited that Owen and I quickly run to the table to draw a welcome home sign for them. What a great idea. Soon, we hear the car honking and see Daddy pulling up into the driveway very slowly. There must be precious cargo in that car, I say. He parks and quickly runs to the other side of the car to open the door. Mommy gets out, but no baby. As we hold our breaths for what seems like an eternity, Daddy reaches in and pulls out a car seat with the tiniest little human we have ever seen in real life. Our sister, Bailey Ann Aria Garcon, was finally home. By the way, we picked her middle name. We jump off the couch to meet them at the door. Daddy says, "You can't touch her with dirty hands." So we dash to the sink to wash our hands. Owen pushes me so that he can be first. "I'm the oldest, so you have to wait after me," I cry. Fortunately, that excuse works and I get to hold Bailey first. Things have really changed around here. Bailey Ann is now 5 days old and the world revolves around her. I miss time with mommy, but I know she has to take care of Bailey, so I try to help as much as I can. Thank goodness I have my list to help me. Mommy is crying in her room and I ask, "What's wrong, mommy?" "Oh, nothing, baby. I'm just so happy that Bailey Ann is home. Aren't you?" Mommy replies. Then she hugs me. But I know what mommy's happy cries look like, and that's not it. I find mommy crying in the bathroom again, and I ask, "Are those happy tears again, mommy?" She says they are, but I know what mommy's happy cries look like, and that's not it. That night, I hear mommy crying in the bedroom with daddy. Daddy says, "It's okay, sweetie, I'm here for you." But mommy says no words. She just continues to cry. The next morning before daddy goes to work, he tells us to make sure that we help mommy in any way that she needs us to help. He also reminds us to call him if we need help. "Yes, daddy. Yes, we know, daddy. If we can't get in touch with you, then call Tati." We both cry together. Daddy tells us the same thing every day. Daddy leaves for work and Mommy is still sad. I get my list to see how I can help to make Mommy happier. So I have Owen clean up the living room while I make breakfast. We get right to work and in no time we're done. Mommy loves it. She cries again. Those tears were happy tears because I know what Mommy's happy cries look like, and that was it. Days pass by and Mommy keeps crying. Is there something more I need to do to help? Daddy works, so he can't help much until he gets home. I look through my list again, but I'm almost all out of options. Mommy, I see you crying again. How can I help you? I ask. This time, Mommy says nothing and she continues to cry. So I call Daddy, but there's no answer. I know what to do, I say. Call Tati. Tati is funny and she always knows how to cheer Mommy up. Tati comes right over and sees that Mommy is not her usual self. Munchie, you're such a responsible big sister and you did the right thing by calling someone when you needed help, she says. That makes me feel really proud of myself. I smile a big smile. Tati takes Mommy upstairs to the room and tells Owen and me to keep a close eye on Billy Ann and her bassinet. This is a big job, so I give Owen a pep talk to get him ready. I get my list and decide that we're each going to read our favorite book to Billy. What a great plan. I finish reading my book, and now it's Owen's turn. While Mommy and Tati are upstairs, I can hear Mommy breathing hard saying, I'll be okay. I'll be okay. Tati responds, yes, you will be okay, but right now, you're not. What you're feeling happens to many new moms. It's just new to you. Let's find someone you can talk to about these new feelings you're having. Owen is taking this job so seriously. Maybe he can be a helper now and not just an entertainer. They come back downstairs as soon as Owen completes his last sentence. Tati asks us to take a seat so she can talk to us. Mommy sits too, but doesn't look our way. Tati says, you guys are such superstars. The way you've been helping Mommy while Daddy is at work is something that responsible kids do. So as a reward, I'm taking you out for a surprise fun day tomorrow. Of course, Owen jumps up and does a cartwheel. Only Owen. I'm happy too, but I ask, well, what about Mommy? We can't leave her alone. Tati responds, look at you being so concerned about Mommy. She's so lucky to have you. We smile. Tati continues, Mommy will be out too. She's going to talk to some people about her new experiences with Billy and how it's making her feel. This will be a good thing for Mommy, just to help her be her best self for all of you. Do you understand? Are you talking about the feelings that make her cry a lot? I ask. Exactly, replies Tati. This sounds like a great idea. I miss the old Mommy, and hopefully the talks she has with those people will help her come back to us. In the meantime, I will keep my list close by so that I never run out of ways to help Mommy, because that's what big sisters do. Note to reader. Having a new baby can make moms feel different things. Sometimes the feelings are happy ones, and sometimes they're sad ones. This does not mean that Mommy doesn't love her baby. Mommies just have a lot of emotions going on at the same time, and sometimes they can't control how they're feeling. But you can help. If you ever see signs of Mommy being more sad than happy, reach out to another adult and let them know. Mommy may need to talk to someone about her feelings so that she can get the help she needs to be her best self for you. Don't be afraid to ask someone for help. It's a huge responsibility that everyone will thank you for. That's one of the biggest and most important ways that you can help Mommy. I hope you enjoyed my book. It was so much fun reading it to you. And I have a fun fact about myself. I actually used to work at PPA. I was a teacher, a first grade teacher. So it's so good to be back in this way. Thank you so much for having me, and I hope you enjoyed it. Bye.